Oh, Josh is on again. That's a big one, dude. That's a, there, I'm on. There we go, I'm on. All right. Double. Oh, and I'm on again. Start jigging again, and I'm on again. Oh, Dad's hooked up. And I'm on again. There's number four. Oh, it's perch. That's a pretty decent perch. That's a keeper perch, guys. Wow. I've got a good one on. I've got a good one. Oh, wait, what?
Well, as you can see, I'm in the truck. And another reason for that is because I fell in.
Alrighty, Josh, how many fish?
We got 120. There was 60 even in each bucket. Like, what are the chances of that?
Alrighty, guys, welcome to Saratoga Springs. There's a lot of people out on the ice today, but that's okay because they're all catching fish. So we're gonna slide down this little dock here and we're gonna go catch some white bass. So stay tuned. Let's go catch some fish. Oh, Josh is on. Got another one. Oh, my. Oh, Josh is on again. That's a big one, dude. That's a, there, I'm on. There we go, I'm on.
Look at this one.
All right. Double. Oh. Triple, we got a triple. All three of us hooked up on one. That's awesome. There we go, guys. Look at that. White bass. Josh got a big one, dude. Look at that, guys. White bass.
All right, so hi, it's me from the future. I just realized I forgot to announce this is going to be an episode of the 100 fish challenge. This is episode 9 of the 100 fish challenge, and I'm just gonna say it right now, guys. We caught a ton of fish for the challenge, so I forgot to say it, so I'm saying it now. Thanks for watching, and editor, resume footage.
Yeah,
that's so I want to.
All right, I've got one. Josh has three now.
Three.
Oh, and I'm on again. Dad, I didn't even have time to jig it once, and I had one on. Insane white bass bite. Insane. Absolutely insane white bass bite. That one's a small one. He's going back in the hole. See you later, dude.
Look at that guy.
All right, that's two for me. I literally dropped down, got to bottom, reeled up my slack. Start jigging again. And I'm on again. Oh my gosh. That's already three fish for me in about a minute. Oh, Dad's hooked up. And I'm on again. There's number four. Oh, it's perch. That's a pretty decent perch. That's a keeper perch, guys. Wow. Look at that. That's a keeper. Not as big as this one. Keeper perch. In the bucket he goes. Oh, I've got a good one on. I've got a good one. Oh, wait, what? Oh, Dad! Look at the size of that little guy. Okay, the big one's off. That one's a keeper right there. We're throwing him in the bucket, but the little dude, he's going back in the water. In the bucket he goes. Oh, and Josh is on. Okay, this is insane. Holy crap. What is that? I'm at five now, five, six. I just got two at once. In a lake he goes. And I'm on. So Josh, you drop right directly down to the bottom. That's how I'm getting all mine. I'm just dropping it right to the bottom and they're slamming it. There we go.
That's five now.
This is seven. Seven for me right here. Fish number seven. He's going back. You can be picky about what fish you catch. That's how good the fishing is. Oh, Josh got one. You don't even have to reel. You just pull it up.
That's how I do it. I just
I just pull it all the way up.
That's a decent one, Josh.
Look at that guy.
That's a nice one, Josh.
That makes six now. Yep. Sam, I think I'm gonna lose count. Like,
that's how happened. Well, I think I'm at seven or eight or six.
Seven. This next one that you're gonna catch.
There you go. I'm on.
Okay.
Oh, they're fun on the ultralight. So much fun. I love it because you can be picky about what ones you want to keep or what you don't. There's number eight right there, boys. There we go. Look at that, guys. That is insane. And he goes. This is insane. Oh, there we go. There's a fish. All right, hook comes out. There's number nine. Oh, this is insane. Oh, that was a big bite. Oh, that's a big one. There we go. Biggest one for me. That's a chunk. He hit that really hard. That's a keeper. That one's going in the bucket for sure. And they are just engulfing it. Oh my gosh. That is insane. Oh, Josh is hooked up. Another nice guy.
Oh, that's a...
We almost filled the bucket. Okay. I wonder if we can find a lure that doesn't work.
I really want to catch one of those, or I want to catch a perch. It would be my first. If that's a perch, I'm going
to pick. It's a dink.
Oh my goodness. It's like...
That's 11. Catching 11 fish in 5 minutes. Oh my gosh, this is insane. They're hitting it so good.
Mine is now at 8.
Nice little dude.
Oh my goodness, Sam. I'm just fishing on Sam's channel is that you don't have to like make sure your fish stay cold or anything.
Yes.
They won't go bad. They'll just sit there and yep. Freeze.
Nature's refrigerator. This is insane. Guys, come out to Utah Lake. Bring just a dual curly tail grub rig or even a single curly tail grub. That's what Josh is using. Just drop it down to the bottom and you are going to have a good time. This is a great way to get kids into fishing because, I mean, you're almost guaranteed to catch a lot of fish and hard fighting fish. For the subscribers, how would you rate the trip so far?
What's the rating scale?
On... Like, on everything, like how are you, like on how many fish you've caught, how cold are you, like.
It's cold because first of all, it's like windy as you can see, but if you can see the snow.
Oh, I just had one as you pulled that one up.
Oh, that would have been awesome.
That would have been like the most double, that would have been the best double of all time. There was another one I just missed. Okay, I need to get my game together here.
Now that guy's a fighter.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay. Just missed three. Three in a row. I'm not missing the next one. Yep, I am. What?
That makes 10.
10 for you? I'm at 11.
I'm almost there, Sam.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I can feel there's a lot of small ones down there. There's a decent one. Oh, wow. Yeah, he's fighting. Another decent little guy. That guy goes in the bucket. I think.
What Sam catches a shark. Another decent little guy.
There you go. Come on, be a crappie. Oh, another nice white bass. Bass, he's going back in the water. Oh, I missed. Fine, you know what? Fine, he'll just stay there. Oh, missed him. Really good. There we go. There we go. Come on, be a jumbo perch. Nope, it's a jumbo white bass. Oh, there we go. So it's interesting because they're hitting the top jig, they're hitting the bottom jig, they're hitting all the jigs. Back in.
Sam, your aim is by far the most
important. Yep, my aim is just rubbish. Oh, come back. Nope. No, come back. There we go. A nice little white bass. You got this, little buddy. There he goes. Hey guys, well, as you can see, I'm in the truck, and the reason for that is because I fell in. It's not really a big deal. Like I said, I don't know if I mentioned it, but you know, there is like that, safe 3 to 4 inches of ice. And this happens with any ice fishing scenario. There's always gonna be those areas where there's just this soft patch of ice. Just a total human mistake could happen to anyone just walking. Fortunately, just one leg went through, not like all of me, just one leg went through. And got my gloves wet. Nope, I just dumped all the water out of my boot. Just because whenever, you know, you do fall in, you don't want to stay out there, you know, get hypothermia, stuff like that, it's not good. So, it does suck that I have to be away from the fishing for a little bit, but at least I get to not lose my foot. So, we're just going to chill in here, let everything warm up again, then we're going to go back out and keep ice fishing. So, the fishing is so hot, guys. Hey guys, so I am done of waiting, and I need to get back out here, so... Did you miss me?
I should.
Oh, there you go. Oh, that feels decent. Oh yeah, that's a good one. That's the best one for me for the day.
Nice as well.
Oh, okay, yeah, this hole's better. Oh wow, another chungus. And he's off.
Weird with that white bass.
You don't even have time to put your hands back in your pocket, and just like that, you've got another fish on. I found myself a little.
Some bigger fish. Come on, get off. Get off the hook. Come on.
There we go. Oh, he came shooting up the hole like a Coke. Oh, it's exhausting catching this many fish. Yeah. And we're off. I've lost count. Get out of here, pal. Nope. Nope. Get in the hole. Go. Okay, I think I might have a nice one. Yep. Oh. There's another one. Oh, I might have a nice one on here. Yep, sure enough. Alright guys, so it got really windy, so we're gonna move spots to a place that is a little less windy. So, like, a lot of people don't know this, but Utah Lake is a natural lake, but they built a dam. For some reason, I don't know, but anyway, we're gonna go over there. It's more shaded from the wind, so let's get over there. And Josh, give the subscribers a detailed description of the trip so far. Like, how's it been?
Okay, so we've been fishing and catching tons and tons of white bass.
That is true.
Sam caught a perch, and it's been very windy and cold, but it's been so much fun that we got sick of catching fish. That's why we're in here going to another area.
Do you have any tips for the subscribers? Nope. All right.
Bring extremely warm clothes.
That is a good tip.
And a portable heater.
That is a good tip. All right, interview time with Josh is over. Let's get to the inlet place. Something's up here. There's no way it's that shallow, though. Okay, so we were gonna head over to the other place. Ice was not incredibly thick, and it was not very deep, so we're coming back here and try to catch more. So stay tuned, and let's see if we can't get ourselves up to 20 more. Thank you. There's another one. Oh, we got the dink.
Walleye bait. Catfish bait.
Go.
Oh, that's a big one.
Get out of here.
Thank you.
Go.
Oh my gosh, these are so fun. Especially on the ultralight. Get back in there.
Oh, I got a good one. Okay, I've got a nice one. Oh yeah. Oh yeah! That's a keeper right there if I ever saw one. Oh, I just missed one. Another nice guy. Oh, dude, he choked that. Look at that. Absolutely choked it. Medium-sized guy. Oh, I've got another big one.
I think. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
He's hooked funny. That's it. Look, Dad, it's a pretty decent sized one, but he was also hooked funny. So that made him fight really hard. Oh, there's one. There's a whitey.
Yay!
Truly makes me laugh how many fish are here, and it doesn't matter how many people fish for them, they consistently continue to bite in this lake. I love how catching a fish anymore isn't even a big deal. Oh, another nice one. Me. Oh my gosh. Bro, the biggins came out.
No. Oh. Oh. Ooh, I like what I hear. Okay, show them to the camera. Just tell the camera about it. Alrighty guys, Josh just caught, is that your first ever perch?
Yes. So pretty.
Oh, there's a fish. Alright, anything else you want to say to the subscribers about your perch, or you just want to throw him back?
He's a little guy.
Yep.
Nice and little.
But he's a first.
Yeah, buddy.
Meanwhile, I just got one. Nice little white bass. Let's get him back in the water.
So, we just got back, and that is the pile of all of the fish. Josh, what are we going to do with all these fish?
We're going to flame them all, and we're going to have a giant fish fry.
That's right, a gigantic fish fry with all of these plus the random perch. So yeah, are you excited?
Wait, there's one more perch somewhere in there.
Yeah, somewhere in there.
We'll
there's
find
another
it
perch.
Later.
Are you excited, Josh?
Yes. Yes, all this right. Is going to be amazing.
So we're going to count all these up, put them in the buckets, and then we're going to go get cooking.
Yeah.
One. There's one. Alrighty, Josh, so how many fish?
We got 120. There was 60 even in each bucket. Like, what are the chances of that?
So we kept 120 and let go who knows how many. So
probably at least 200.
We probably caught at least 200 fish today. That is insane. So anyway, it's time to start filleting. And here goes our biggest catch and cook yet. Alrighty, guys, so now I'm going to quickly show you just kind of how to fillet a white bass. I'm not going to record the filleting of every fish, just this one. So basically what I like to do is I like to take the gill plate, fold that fin up, and just cut directly behind the gill plate, just like that.
And then there's a lot of different ways to do it. A lot of people just like to cut down to the backbone like I'm doing now, and then just turn and cut it that way, but I like to do it a little bit of a different way. Just get that good cut there. All right, so once you cut that, you're gonna go down the back like that, and then gotta get it in there. And then once you get down there, just cut along the back of the fish, just like that. And then just let it come along, but don't put it all the way through the fish until you get to right about there, right around the anus area. Poke the knife all the way through. I'm gonna flip it just to make it a little bit easier for me to work. And then you just standard fillet that down, fold it up, and then just slowly, or here, I'll bring it a little closer to you guys, and then just slowly peel that meat off using the knife, just like this. And then just slowly do it. And then you'll notice there's some blood on there, but I mean, that's just normal. What you do after that is just skin it, where you pinch the skin and then just cut the meat right off the skin. White bass have thick skin, so it's hard to mess this part up. It's hard to end up accidentally cutting through the skin. I mean, just like that. Dad did it actually, and then, like that, you've got a white bass fillet. Then do that on both sides and do it all over again.
What's up, subscribers? You guys were the best. Be sure to click subscribe and leave a like.
Hey guys, so we have been filleting white bass for... We have been filleting for like a long time. As you can see, the current time is 6:10.
That is a funky one. Try asking me for a spooky balloon.
Alexa, play time's over.
That was a small.
Alrighty, guys, so we've been playing for a long time. I'm starting to get tired, so I think it's time we should start cooking. Alrighty, guys, so it's time to start cooking. So today we're going to be doing something different. As you guys know, I love this stuff. This stuff is so, so good. And I went and bought the other three flavors, used some of this on a video, on a not video. And long story short, we're gonna be trying all three different kinds to see which one we like best. All right, we're gonna start out by putting the spicy one in first, the extra uber spicy one. There we go, big healthy serving there.
Is it recording?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry!
Are you just gonna put it on mute?
Yeah, I'm editing all this part out.
Why?
Why not? Why should I include the part of me drinking milk?
I mean, like, why not, put you putting the ingredients in fast motion?
Oh, no, I'm adding that in. It's just the part of us talking in the background that I'm taking out.
Well, you could literally put it on mute and just have music play. That might be better than...
But I'm standing around drinking milk, so it'd just be a time lapse of me doing absolutely nothing. You make things so complicated, Josh. Look at that chunk of white bass fillets. That is absolutely insane. That's like, oh, I don't know, 10 pounds maybe of white bass fillets. That is a lot of meat. Okay, so I actually changed my mind. I'm gonna put the breading in this bag. And the reason for that is because it makes it so much easier to coat the fish. I've always done it with a bowl, but I just barely started doing it this way and I found I like it a lot better. Coats the fish really good, so. And a little bit more of that stuff in there. Don't be shy with your fish fry, folks. In the bag she goes. And I just realized I forgot to
poker eggs. Yep. We shake it around. Make sure those fish are nice and very fully breaded. All right, here goes the first fillet into the hot oil. Woo, doggy. Oil, do not stick your fingers in that. All right, well, you guys probably can't see it right now, but we've got the doors open and the fan going because in the process of getting Josh and all his fish packed up, we ended up leaving the oil on the stove. So when you're cooking with oil, one, do not do it without parents. Unless you are a parent, then you can. And never leave your oil unattended. That's all I have to say. All right, we've got all the stuff. Alright, so I have done this recipe in a lot of my past videos. I'm actually working on creating a playlist of all my catch and cook videos, so I'll put a link to that playlist in the description below. But anyways, I'm going to be doing just a very simple recipe. It's just your standard fish taco, which is basically, well, a taco with fish and a bunch of other delicious stuff. So anyway, let's get started. Alright, so we're going to start out doing a taco with the... Oh shoot, I can't remember what one is the spicy and what one's not. Well, taste test. Okay, that's the spicy one. Oh goodness, yep, that is 100% the spicy one. So spicy, oh god. Eat your greens, kids. Some cilantro lime. Which is cilantro and lime. If you didn't know already. There you go. That's your fish taco. So simple, so easy, and it took no time to make. Alright Dad, what flavor of fish are you trying?
These are the spicy Cajun, white bass, fish taco, with the spinach, the cilantro lima crema, and whatever else Sam crammed in.
That's all. What do you think of it? Is it very, very, very good? Do you have any descriptive words?
Well, it's pretty much like Cabo San Lucas in a tortilla.
That is a good way to put it. Thank you for your time, sir.
It is delicious.